Hey everyone. Welcome back to the Riffsphere channel. In this video, we'll be configuring our 4K instance of Sonarr. If you followed our 1080p Sonarr video, you should already have the necessary folders set up. Head over to the Docker tab and open the Sonarr 4K web UI. Just like before, we need to configure authentication. So set a username and password. Next, go to the general section in the settings menu and add the URL, username, password, and API for Sonarr 4K to flat notes. Mind you that my flat notes in this video will not be up to date. I updated in between videos. While we are here, let's change the port to 8990 to keep it consistent with our Docker configuration. Before saving, you can also disable data collection. After changing the port, Sonarr will prompt to restart, which will temporarily make the page unavailable. Go back to the Docker tab, select the Sonarr 4K installation and enable the advanced view. Remove the web UI port, and click on the plus button. Set the config type to port, name it web UI, and set both the container and host port to 8990. Click on add. Update the web UI link to use port 8990 as well. Apply the changes. Our Sonarr 4K instance is now available again. Login if required. Go to settings, then profiles, and remove all default profiles. On the recycler wiki, click on the 4K profile and copy the profile name from the quality profiles. Create a new profile in our Sonarr 4K instance. Paste the name, and select a 4K options. Recycler will handle the rest for us. Save the changes. Under Media Management, enable Advanced Mode again. Select Rename Episodes and update the format for Standard, Daily, and Anime Episodes, as well as the Series and Season folder formats according to Trash Guide suggestions. At the bottom, click on Add Root Folder and select our 4K folder. Don't forget to save. Just like before, we'll skip the indexers. Add your download clients using the Sonarr 4K category and connect Sonarr 4K to your media center. Let us know in the comments what download client you prefer, so we can look into covering that if we haven't already. As a final step, we want to copy all series from our 1080p instance. Go to the import list section, click the plus button, and select Sonarr. Change the name to Sonarr and enter the URL for our other Sonarr instance. Since both instances are on our custom network, you can use http://sonarr8989. Grab your Sonarr API from Flatnotes and enter it here. If everything is correct, you should see your profile when you click the quality profiles. Select the 1080p profile to sync. Clicking the test button should show a green check mark. If not, double check your settings and click save. And just like that, our 4K instance of Sonarr is set up. It will sync all series from our other instance and keep its files and downloads separate. As always, don't forget to add Sonarr 4K to Heimdall and enable the auto start option on the Docker tab. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe for more content.